2K Sports Pregame Show, sponsored by Sprite.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to 2K Sports. I'm your host, Ernie Johnson, joined by the Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, it'll be the Philadelphia 76ers going up against the New York Knicks. Taking a look at the Knicks. They've had a tough time over the last few weeks, 3-7 in their last 10 games. We'll see if they can make amends tonight. Brett Brown's one of the newer NBA head coaches in Philadelphia. What do the Sixers want from him?
Well, he's a Spurs guy. He was an assistant under Popovich. He brings a new approach to offense that his team hasn't seen in a long time. He's also a system guy. He knows how to develop a system that...
And now, the starting lineup. At center, at 6 foot 9 inches, number 21, Lou Alexander. Point guard at 6'3", number 3, Jose Calderon.
We're coming at you from beautiful New York City as the Knicks prepare to take the home court. Well, guys, for the Philadelphia 76ers, they come in off a loss to Phoenix. And guys, the hometown fans not pleased with that dreadful performance.
Team get knocked out cold.
And what stands out from that game, Clark, is that they let a lot of points slip through their fingers at the free throw line.
Yep, and I think some doubt started to creep in as well when they kept missing their foul shots. Guys seem to tighten up and start alligator arming those things.
Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. Tony Roten out there with Hollis Thompson. Then it's Robert Covington. Then it's Dub. And it's Noel in at the four slot.
And there's the first bucket of the game.
Yeah, that's a nice tone setter out of the gate.
Calderon dishes to Carmelo. Anthony left side. Back to Calderon. Shot clock at 6. Blocked.
He's coming off a 16-point game against Phoenix.
Covington passes to Okafor. He goes up again. Aflalo pulls it in.
And they force the miss with that good defensive rotation. They're playing well together as a unit.
Dishes to Calderon. Drains it from beyond the arc.
A chance he can have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter.
Just a lot of disappointment for the Knicks last year and their fans, as many were hoping for them to challenge for the East title, but it just never came together. A fragile line between being a playoff team and not.
Philadelphia on D. This their first look at this year's New York squad.
Well, these are a pair of conference rivals that are going to be very familiar with each other by the end of the season. So this is just the first of 4 games they'll see each other. Very well done. He is a confident, dynamic scorer.
The 76ers have gone 2-for-4 from the field so far today. Here's Roten, and he bangs it home with one hand. Savage, that's the way to get some momentum on your side.
Absolutely. Those dunks can really have a deflating effect on the defense.
Especially coming from a guy out of the backcourt.
Now here's Aflalo. Not too proud of his numbers in that game against the Timberwolves, that's for sure.
Starting out this series, Clark, they're just, you know, getting a feel for each other, feeling out this year's roster.
That's exactly right, Kevin. You know, in the early season, you do a little scouting. This is where you get your bearings and kind of figure out what you need to do to beat those guys. I love these rivals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's smart basketball. You foul and you send a very poor free throw shooter to the line.
Yeah, I think that's just smart. I mean, especially the way he's been throwing it down. Make him earn it at the stripe.
The 76ers shooting their initial free throws of the game right here. He misses the free throw.
You know, the Sixers, quite honestly, since 2003, have been a team stuck on that treadmill of mediocrity, never winning more than 43 games. You know, last season, the organization finally committed to a full overhaul and rebuild.
Now, here's Calderon, averaging 6 points per contest. There's a good screen. The feed to Carmelo. Six on the shot clock. Here's O'Quinn. And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
And the Sixers' rebuild really started in earnest during the 2013 draft when they traded away their all-star point guard Drew Holiday to New Orleans for two separate first-round picks. A defining move, I think, to strategically weaken the team while acquiring assets.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Kev, Derek Fisher and I got a chance to talk for a bit. This is their first matchup of the season against this squad, and he knows the shot blocking in the middle will certainly be an obstacle. But he said, quote, we've got to remain aggressive and continue to attack. Guys, he said that putting their bigs in high pick and rolls and shooting the open jumper with confidence will be key. We'll see how they do.
Okay, Doris, thanks. It's almost like a crucial aspect to enabling your offense. You first have to get around this stifling defense, don't you?
Yeah, and I think the key, Kevin, is being the aggressor right from the outset of this game.
That means being in attack mode and not passing up any good shots that you get early.
First one falls for him. And you look at last season for the Sixers. Yes, they were a losing team, but a losing team with a plan.
Yeah, you know, that's right, Kevin. Coach Brown said that they had six NBA players and a bunch of guys fighting for a spot. But as time passes and you see this young talent develop, I think they do have a chance to be pretty special.
Well, Carmelo Anthony's free agent decision, subject to much speculation and hand-wringing in New York over the last season. But in the end, he decided to remain with the Knicks, much to the relief of the hometown faithful.
Here's Okafor, and that's off the glass and in. Okafor's got his second bucket.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
The Knicks have gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. Calderon with it. A follow outside. Stolen by Thompson. For the finish.
What a throwdown there. Man.
Here he comes, and there he goes.
Look at him punish that rack.
You know, the guys on the bench are going crazy right now at the sight of that jam.
Here's Calderon. A follow outside. It's up a three. And he gets it to go. Aflalo's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Clark and Steve, this tug-of-war game continues.
You know what? And they just keep flip-flopping the lead again and again and again.
Yeah, how about that last lead change, guys? That's number 7 for the game. That's an easy shot there. That's a shot that he should make more often than not.
Calderon with it. Picked up by Thompson. Aflalo right side. Pass to Calderon. Back to Aflalo. 5 on the clock. Calderon against Thompson. Calderon, no good. Here's Covington. The shot is off. Excellent D there from Aflalo. The Knicks with the lead. Now Calderon. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Knicks will retain possession.
And while we have a chance to do so, let's take a look at some of the numbers for Tony Roten. He's averaging 19 points a game, 6 assists, and almost 2.5 steals. And those are tremendous assist totals.
You don't
need the numbers, really, to see just how confident he is with the ball in his hands.
Yeah, that's really accurate, Steve. I mean, he is loving playing the quarterback for them.
And so New York calls timeout. They're first, coming off that loss against the Timberwolves.
It was not a very inspired performance for them, particularly defensively. I thought, they gave the hostile crowd a lot to cheer about, frankly.
Yeah, they allowed a lot of free runs to the hoop, a lot of open jumpers, and in the end, the opponent's shooting percentage was right through the roof, and you can't win when that's the case.
Noel with the block. And Thompson kicks to Roten. Okafor with the ball. He's against Amundsen. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Noel dishes to Roten. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. These youthful Sixers, Clark, really trying to play a full tilt, open court style.
Yeah, they want to play up tempo under head coach Brett Brown. And he said he doesn't want to control pace. He wants reckless abandon under control.
And the Sixers' aggressive style, a stark contrast to the way they played not that long ago. And they were one of the most conservative teams in the league, looking to avoid turnovers and often settling for two-point jump shots.
Catching up on the changes for New York, the bulldozer, he's jacked in for Amundsen. Williams comes in for Kyle O'Quinn. And it's Grant in for Jose Calderon.
And these two teams continuing to trade blows like heavyweights in the middle of the ring.
So many times tonight, the energy in this building has gone from one way to the other. And the Sixers last season led the league in pace of play, shooting about 25% more three-pointers than everybody else. Even their big men took shots from long range beyond the arc. Really a fun style to watch. And I think it's exactly the way they need to go as they rebuild.
Here's Covington. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Here's Okafor. The rebound by Grant. The Knicks have gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. Anthony drives in.
Oh, get it! Oh, watch out now!
I'm not sure how I like this. He used the rim to get some true hang time there.
Now, he just wanted to make sure the landing was softer than the take.
Okay, I'll buy that. I'll buy that for now.
And the 76ers decide to take their first timeout here.
Well, we now know that Carmelo Anthony was battling through a torn rotator cuff and a torn labrum in the 2013 playoffs. Surgery seemed likely, and he would have missed the start of last season, but instead he went for a combination of rest and rehab, and that did the trick, and he seemed really healthy all year.
A different look for New York. Early, he's checked in for Anthony, and it's Ricky Lito in for Aaron Aflalo.
Well, with the shakeups for the Knicks, with the coaching change and even the change in the front office during last season, you'd absolutely expect them to take on a new direction.
They had a little bit of a hiccup to get the overhaul started, but once summer was in full swing, Clark, the Knicks made a lot of changes.
Well, getting Fisher to coach and then implement the triangle was a big one, and they also made some trades to shake up a roster that many felt underachieved last year.
A free throw drops for Roten.
Roten putting up the numbers. He's already got 8 points, and 4 of his points have come at the foul line. He's made the most of those opportunities.
Which can't be undervalued, Clark. So many times a game can come down to which team wins the free throw battle. The defense was ready for him that time, and they had to be. He is so powerful in the lane.
And he stuffs it in on the jam.
He can fly, can he? He'll make you forget he's a point guard sometimes, Clark.
Yeah, when he does decide to attack the basket, Kevin, he can do it with the best of them.
And this is the time to attack with these two teams locked in such a close game.
So it's the Knicks now. 76ers getting the bucket. Early kicks to Lito. Now the pass to the bulldozer. Can't get it to go. And Philadelphia the other way now. Here's Roten. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Roten's got 12 in the game. New York trailing. From 10 feet out. And it's good off the back rim and in.
Both teams on fire right from the opening tip.
Pedal to the throttle, Steve. Just like we like it.
Okafor with a screen on Grant. Roten kicks to Thompson. Nailed from three-point land. Thompson's got his second basket of the night.
You know, the defense didn't exactly try to fight around that screen, and that's why it turned into the easy basket.
Pass to the Bulldozer. Here's Lido. 11 points for him in that last game against Minnesota. The Bulldozer passes to Grant. Lock at six. Doubled by Roten. That's good.
And they're beginning to fall apart a little bit defensively, especially inside.
Well, that's four straight buckets now at the rim.
1:14 left in the first quarter. Feeds it to Okafor. Tries again. And he lays it up and in. Okafor's got 6 points.
Hasn't been able to get it going offensively. It's been a slow start for him.
New York calls timeout.
And what was really the big shock in the East last season, the Knicks failed to make the playoffs. This from a team many expected to challenge for a spot in the conference finals. Just didn't happen.
Embiid, he's checked in for Philadelphia. And one of the trademarks of the many best point guards in the league, their ability to score in addition to distribute. So here now a look at the top scoring point guards this season. Tony Roten, fourth.
Well, this is a collection of maybe the most well-rounded players in the league. To see those kinds of scoring numbers from the point guard position is crazy.
Yeah, it's wacko. That's sort of the era we're in right now, though. A point guard who consistently takes things into his own hands is fucked.
Oh! Hammer time! Wow. Hammer time!
The defense looking a little bit dazed now. A ferocious throw down there.
Not bad for a player of his size.
Not bad at all. How about that spring coming out of those legs?
Grant dishes to Williams. And now Philadelphia on the break. Roten with the ball.
And once he took off, it looked like the defense just had no interest in getting in his way.
That's one where you just give up the 2 points and move on.
Knicks trail by 7. Here's Lido. No good off the back of the rim.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
Yeah, and even though it's early, I mean, that's a great sign for them for the rest of the game.
And that one's good. Noel.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they've just given them too many looks inside.
Yeah, I mean, they're just getting pounded in there. The defense not offering much resistance. They've got to force the ball back out to the perimeter.
Shot to stop the run. It's blocked. Now here's Roten. A shot by Thompson and no one's around. And that does it for the first quarter. Philadelphia ahead, leading by 9. Let's take a quick break now, and then it's on to the second quarter after this.
Next Friday night, November 28th, Chris Paul and the Los Angeles Clippers take on James Harden and the Houston Rockets.
Welcome back, everyone. We're ready to get going again as this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports continues. Players are topped off with Gatorade, hydrated, and ready to get going again as well. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for Philadelphia.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
Well, the other thing they've done well is getting after shooters. They've closed out well, and they really blocked a lot of shots in the half.
And so, in the game for the 76ers, Robert Covington out there with no... Embiid, then it's Hollis Thompson, and it's Roten in at the point guard. Aaron Aflalo, he's checked in for Grant. Grant, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Isaiah Cannon comes in for Thompson. And here are the Knicks now. They trail by 7. Calderon kicks to O'Quinn. Pass to Aflalo. No luck. And Philadelphia the other way now. Cannon, the pass to Embiid. It's rebounded by New York. Let's check out what Doris Burke has for us.
Well, Kevin, Derek Fisher going straight from his playing to his new job as the Knicks head coach. He brushed aside questions about his lack of experience, saying, basketball is a game that I'm experienced in playing, understanding, leading in, and helping achieve the greatest gift in the world as an athlete, and that's being a champion. Not bad, guys.
A lack of confidence. He understands well, Doris. Thanks.
Well, early on in the season still, but Kevin, it's time to take a look at where the 76ers sit right now in the league stats. First in steals, second in fewest turnovers per game, and they're ranked third overall in team offense. This is a team that knows how to put the ball in the basket, and really that's their strong suit.
Yeah, Clark, this is a team that scares opponents because of that steals number that you talked about. They're so good at anticipating plays. They seem to have a good scheme defensively night in and night out. They know their roles. They make their rotations. They read the passing lanes, and they frequently get out there, make steals, and then get out in their transition game.
Another shot. He takes it up and lays it in. Embiid's got his first 2 points of the night.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
Calderon dishes to Amundsen. Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. He gives them a double-digit lead. And now a 10-point 76ers lead. The Knicks have gone 2-of-4 shooting the ball here in the second. New York calls timeout.
Well, they're getting way too many easy shots in the paint. So this timeout is specifically for that reason. You got to tighten up the defense and start to make it harder for that offensive team.
I know it's easier said than done, but right now it just doesn't seem like the necessary effort is there.
And some changes here for the 76ers. Dove comes in for Noel. And Stauskas subbed in for Roten. Calderon a screen on Okafor. Here's Amundsen. Loses his man. The screen and lays it up and in. Amundsen's got his first basket.
The guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark, just piling up points in the paint.
And Jose Calderon gets the whistle that time.
He's jammed himself up a little bit here with that second foul. But as long as he can avoid a third before the half, I think he's fine.
Here's Kanan. He's coming off a 22-point game against Phoenix. Embiid kicks to Grant. He feeds it to Okafor. 4 on the clock. And the rebound goes to the Knicks.
I thought he rushed it a little bit, guys, because he had a clean look, just lost his focus.
Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season. Take a look at the Knicks, lurking in the basement of the conference for the time being. They're not pleased with their performance so far this season. And checking out Philadelphia, a game and a half out.
I think looking at the Sixers, they've proven they have a long way to go if they're going to be a competitive team in this league.
And even if they weren't expected to play at a high level this year, I think most people felt they were capable of being better than what they're showing right now.
Both free throws good from Anthony.
Melo having a terrific game. He has 12 points, and he's managed to get 4 of his points by way of the free throw line.
And that may not be the first thing people notice about his performance, but those are important points nonetheless.
Grant the pass to Stauskas. Okafor kicks to Kanan. They grab their own miss. Embiid dishes to Okafor. And that one's good. Okafor's got 8 points.
Even with the D lurking, he made it look easy with the soft finger roll.
Knicks trail by 8.
Been a couple of whirlwind years for Joel Embiid. Coming from Cameroon, had to learn a new culture, new cuisine, how to drive a car. Now he's a top pick, making millions of dollars a year. That's enough to make anybody's head spin. A lot to adjust to. But with his fluidity and the natural gift he seems to have for the game, I get the feeling this young man is going to be just fine.
His shooting has been so good today. He may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
Here's Kanan. He's guarded by Calderon. Here's Okafor. From the left block, he sends it through. Okafor's got 4 points this quarter. And Embiid with a stress fracture in his back in March, a stress fracture in his foot in June. Clark, those kinds of injuries raise long-term concerns, especially when you're talking about a seven-footer with a very limited basketball resume.
Well, there's no denying that, Kevin. I mean, clearly, if you're a general manager, then you're thinking about what are the prospects of this big, talented, highly gifted player going forward, and only time will tell if this is just an aberration or it's something that's going to be fine.
Anthony, the pass to Calderon. Back to Anthony.
Oh, they're now +5 in the rebound category, really controlling the glass.
And rebounding is one of those non-glamour stats. I mean, it takes work and effort and tenacity and physicality. But when you look at the scoreboard, you can see the correlation.
Boy, he is a strong finisher on the fast break.
Yeah, he sure is. He remains in total control, even at full speed. I love that about him.
Timeout called, the 76ers.
You know, one thing you like about Aaron Aflalo, he's an outstanding post-up player for a guard. At 6'5", he's got a real knack for scoring with his back to the bucket.
Philadelphia will go for a different look here. Noel's checked in for Embiid. Thompson comes in for Grant. Roten's checked in for Stauskas. And it's Jackson in for Cannon. Roten kicks to Noel. Calderon against Jackson. The dish to Roten. And it's Noel missing. And for a follow, Steve. Right around the top 5 in efficiency in the post in the entire NBA last season.
Yeah, and his sweet spot really extends on the court, not just from the post, but all the way to the corners. In fact, he loves to work the baseline, Kevin.
Roten dishes to Noel. And the layup falls. Noel's got his second basket of the night.
You don't need much range to hit from that distance, Kevin.
And a follow kicks to Calderon. To the inside. Here's Anthony. That falls. Nice steal this time from Jose Calderon.
Well, offensively, he's taken a solid opening quarter and just built on it here in the second.
Noel sets a screen for Jackson from outside the arc, and the shot is good. Jackson's got his first 3 points of the game.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
Calderon kicks to Amundsen. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk. They'd love to get more of those, the easiest 2 points possible. And on a fierce finish.
Yeah, and that's exactly how they're going to cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the hoop like that.
Well, I tell you what, it was the good pick that was set that turned him loose.
And once he got around it, Steve, it was smooth sailing right to the hole.
Well, because of the pick, he had plenty of room. That's why he was able to power down that slam.
And a follow kicks to Calderon. Here's Anthony. Makes it off the glass. Anthony's got 10 points now just in this quarter.
He has been fantastic this quarter, guys. It's just the kind of effort they need if they're going to continue to trim the lead.
Noel sets a screen for Jackson. Thompson outside. Knicks with the rebound. Alfalo's got three rebounds so far in the game. To the wing right side. He dishes it to Carmelo. And there's the foul. It'll go on Doug. That's his first foul. So New York ends up going with the new group. To the left side wing. Early, the pass to Lito. Five to shoot. And Thompson sends it back. Now the 76ers on the break. Here's Jackson. Leaps for it, and it's out of bounds. The Knicks will take it the other way. And let's quickly check in on the season's top rookie rebounders so far. You take a look at Okafor. No doubt one of the most efficient rebounders in the game. And, of course, Joel Embiid, even more impressive.
These two guys are animals in the paint. That's the only way to describe them. They devote so much energy to their rebounding.
Steve, they just know how to play in there. And that's something you don't necessarily teach. And it's not just their energy, but a combination of energy, ability, and understanding how to play.
Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris.
Well, gentlemen, we all know Carmelo Anthony signed a new 5-year contract with the New York Knicks. He said in the past that winning was all that mattered to him, so many feared he'd jump ship. Still, in the end, Melo said, "I am a New York Knick at heart. This organization has supported me, and in return, I want to stay and build here with this city and my team." Guys, can he do it? We'll see.
He said his heart never wavered, Doris. He's happy to be back. We're in the orange and blue. Thank you. Stolen by Jackson. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Pretty bad defense, letting the offense get right to the rim, but smart play to foul once he was there.
But you know what's going to happen, and they sent a message right there. Nothing easy inside.
And Carmelo taking a little less money to give the Knicks Clark flexibility to bring in help.
Yeah, he structured his contract so they'd have some wiggle room this coming offseason, showing his commitment to getting them on a winning track, hopefully. I think looking at the Sixers, anytime that you go through a 21-game losing streak during any point of the season, you know you're going to be near the bottom of the conference standings.
1:33 left in the first half of basketball. He kicks it to Roten. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Williams with the steal. And they're running all alone. And the dunk by Grant.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
Yeah, it's one thing to create a turnover, but to so alertly turn it into a transition opportunity, that's even better.
Thompson from long range. Lito with the rebound.
What is surprising about the 76ers last year, they had a long losing streak, but somehow managed not to finish at the bottom of the East.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
And even if it costs them some foul trouble, I mean, they need to start putting some bodies on bodies. Be physical.
Here's Okafor, and it's good. Okafor's got 12 in the game. Well, thinking of Philly in the East again, Clark, the fact that they didn't finish dead last after that losing streak says more about the conference than the 76ers.
Well, I guess I could agree with that. I mean, if you go 14-38 against the rest of the East like the 76ers did, you expect to be at the bottom, but amazingly, they avoided that last year. Actually, I will agree. It was more of a testament to the East and its lack of quality play.
He still couldn't finish, even though it looked like he had a lane to the rim. But too often, that's the story for him.
And here is Grant. He's got 8. Kicks it to Lito. Shot clock at 6. No good with the elbow jumper. Here's Okafor. Shot is off. Close game as we wrap up the second quarter. Knicks lead by 1. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, Jose, I saw you speaking with Coach. How did he critique the team's performance during the first half? And what did he tell you guys to change as that second quarter progressed?
Well, it was just like a kind of like a no effort, like just soft going.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. A fantastic game from Tony Roten in this one.
As effective as he was slashing to the hoop in that first half, he was even better finishing once he got there.
Those were some incredible dunks we saw. I mean, incredible. I can't imagine he'll be able to top those in the last two quarters.
We've got Anthony. Aflalo is out there with Calderon. Then there's Kyle Okun, and it's Admonson in at the center position. That's Derek Fisher's five as we get going into the second half. Here's O'Quinn. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Dishes to Aflalo. Fires at the elbow. Rebounded by Covington.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
Aaron Aflalo coming off his best season yet, Steve, an 18-point-per-game score. Shooting well from the field, three-point range, and the line.
And, Kevin, when you think about the efficiency, it's made even more impressive when you consider that he drew a lot of defensive focus.
The Knicks with the lead. It's Carmelo Anthony on the wing. Aflalo against Thompson. Outside Anthony, 13 feet away, and no good, trying to use the glass.
And that's a shot he had to take.
For sure, it was a good decision, just poor execution.
I don't know what's happening to their defense. I mean, they don't have any effort, any purpose.
And it's really costing them. I mean, the last five baskets at that end have been on very easy looks.
Okafor with a screen on Calderon. Roten dishes to Okafor. Deflects the pass and stolen by Roten to the inside. Taken away. It's two on one. And Aflalo wide open. He shoots. Rebounded by Covington.
1 for 4 from the field since halftime. They're having a tough time getting it going here.
And it's out of bounds. The Knicks will take it the other way. New York leading by 3. Calderon kicks to O'Quinn. They set the pick. Follow against Thompson. Deflects the pass. It's Anthony with the drive. Now the feed to Calderon. Back to Anthony. Passes to Amundsen. Thompson outside. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. To tie. That's good from Roten on the assist by Thompson. 21 points for Roten.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
New York calls timeout.
Hollis Thompson was part of the undrafted Georgetown contingent, getting their chance in Philadelphia last season, playing alongside Henry Sims. And you know, Thompson shot the ball well, showed a lot of promise as a scoring swingman.
And let's take a quick look at the point guards this year, racking up the most steals per game. Number one, Tony Roten.
And all those swipes have come for him because of the endless energy he devotes defensively. And whoever he's guarding, he just stays so close to him on the perimeter.
Yeah, he's the guy, if you're an opposing point guard, that you dread having to go up against. I mean, you don't want to see this guy because, like you said, he's going to be all over you. Like bees on a pop can at a picnic. That's how much he hovers around.
You got away with words, my friend.
Anthony, the pass to Calderon. Back to Anthony. Shot clock at 6. Goes up with a strike. There's the bucket. Cool. Anthony's got 18 points. And Thompson playing solid rotation minutes, shot the ball well, and if anything, could stand to shoot more.
He's got a pretty low scoring rate given his accuracy from all over the court. I think with this quick release, I think he should be looking to shoot it more.
Boy, I tell you what, he's having one of those days where if he takes it, he makes it.
Calderon kicks to Aflalo. The pass to Carmelo. And the Knicks getting another bucket right there.
A large part of what they've been able to do here is centered around his offense.
Okafor sets the pick for Roten. Now Okafor inside. It's rebounded by New York. Omnison's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. It's Anthony with the drive, and that one's good. And it's a four-point Knicks lead.
Room service delivery right there, fellas. Wonderful entry feed.
Roten dishes to Covington. Here's Okafor. Another miss by Okafor.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
Calderon passes to O'Quinn. Shot denied. Thompson outside. Here's Okafor. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Looking at the game for Doug. He has 12 points and a pretty good rebounding performance from him also.
Yeah, he's been establishing terrific position, boxing out very well and battling hard for every rebound.
And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time. Now the playoffs weren't really a goal for the 76ers last year, Steve. They just wanted to get their young players some experience and build a foundation for their future.
And in that respect, they accomplished it. I mean, you have to be careful when rebuilding, however, and that, you know, losing culture doesn't start to take over. So that's the challenge here the next couple of years.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going.
Oh, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
Outside Anthony. Calderon in the corner. There's the triple. And it's Noel with the rebound. Noel's got 5 rebounds tonight. A shot by Thompson. No one's around. Another 3 for Philadelphia.
That's 2 straight quick 3-pointers they've allowed.
They better not make it 3 straight, because now all of a sudden you're looking at a hot streak.
Now here's Calderon. D right on him. Pass to Anthony. Got a piece of it. 3-on-3. A shot by Thompson, and no one's around. And he overshot that one, missing. The Knicks have gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime. 5 out of 11. Tries to keep it alive. Out of bounds, Philadelphia takes possession.
Here's where the New York Knicks sit early in the season in the NBA statistics. 4th in free throw percentage. 6th in blocks. And they're in the top half of the league in fewest turnovers. When you can be in that company, you're giving yourself a chance to be a winning team.
Yeah, you look at the free throw shooting, Clark. It's very impressive. They've been in the top 5, as you talked about, and it's a result of a lot of effort, a lot of concentration. And when you shoot them that well, then you gain confidence and you really start attacking the rim, because you want to go to the free throw line to shoot.
Knicks trail by 3. Calderon kicks to Anthony. Feeds it to Amundsen. Will it go? That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Amundsen's got 8 points.
3 consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. Defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Yeah, they're getting exposed right now.
And then Okafor slams it in. Stupendous rush to the rim and a mighty slam on the end of it.
But through the teeth of some pretty soft D, I can't help but say that.
Well, let's see how that impacts things here, because those kinds of plays sometimes can be game changers on both sides.
Calderon has the open look. Drops in the tray. Calderon's got his second bucket of the night.
I'm not sure who was supposed to pick him up, but somebody's going to get an earful from the coach for leaving him that wide open. He's finding all kinds of ways to get it done. What a quarter he's having.
And Tony Roten gets the whistle there. That's his 3rd foul of the game. A different look for New York.
That's his 3rd personal foul. 2nd team foul.
Here's Early. To the inside. Thompson outside. To the right side. Lets it go from deep. Covington shot is off. For New York, they've gone 7-13 in the 3rd quarter so far. Just above 50%.
Well, a collapse this quarter and turnovers played a...
Sure did, Clark. They gave up 6 points off those miscues, and that seemed to turn the tide.
And the 76ers with a completely new group now. Passes it to Holmes. Inside, here's Kanan. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Boy, nice work inside. Tough to get that shot over a big defender like that.
No, that takes skill and creativity, Steve, particularly on the release to make sure he doesn't get a hand on it.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for Philadelphia.
Well, they're taking high-percentage shots in the paint. I like the way their offense is clicking.
Something that's also benefited them tonight are the turnovers they forced and the points that have come along with those forced turnovers.
Philadelphia moving the ball around. Grant dishes to Embiid. It's stolen by Early. Grant with the ball. He's got eight. Three on three. For the three. Stauskas' shot is off. Poked away. Here's Lido. 7 points in the game. Williams with the stuff.
Kev, he came out of nowhere to slam that one back in.
Well, that's making him pay for letting him get his hands on that rebound.
Yeah, is it ever, Kevin.
.125 left in the third. Grant the pass to Holmes. Knocks down the 10-footer. Boomer's got his first 2 points. Knicks trail by four. Here's Lido. Early kicks to Williams. Shot clock at six. Jumper off the screen. Grant, that's good. Grant's got 10 points in the game.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists. Beautiful job angling his body, shielding the big man from the ball on his way to the basket.
That's really the only way to do it if you're going to take it down there amongst the tall trees. Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Grant, right side. Pass to Embiid. He tries for three. And the rebound collected by Irwin.
No, they haven't been able to open up a big lead, but the rebounds are starting to add up for them. They may be able to pull away a little bit.
Yeah, they've been doing the dirty work inside, Steve, playing a very tough brand of basketball.
Here's Lido. He's got seven. It's Anthony with the drive. And the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
The D cannot forget about him like that. He'll light you up big time.
The Knicks shooting their sixth attempt at the charity stripe in the game.
Well, you got to like the free throw shooting from this club all season long. They're shooting 81%. Those are impressive numbers.
Yeah, in general, they've been very solid. I mean, free throw shooting isn't something they've had to worry about too much this season, guys. Well, I tell you what, that's too good a look to pass up there. Even though it didn't go, that's one you got to take.
It's still anybody's game as we've reached the end of three. It's the Knicks. They lead by one. And do not go away as...
Tune in next Wednesday, November 26th. Paul George and the Indiana Pacers go up against the San Antonio Spurs. Be there.
And it's time now to reveal our State Farm assist of the game today. Steve, it's a big man winning the honor.
Man, it was a no-brainer. This assist was really out of this world. I mean, he had a great understanding of the situation and where the ball had to go.
So on the floor for Philadelphia, they've got Stauskas. Grant is out there with Boomer. Then there's Isaiah Cannon, and it's Embiid in at the five. Boy, right down to the wire here, Clark and Steve. Still anyone's ball game.
Both teams really invested now. I mean, this is the type of game you love to win, and you'd hate to lose.
Oof, boy, after all this energy that both teams have expended, you're right, Clark. This would be a tough one to lose.
Just five on the clock. Here's Grant, the reverse, blocked. And it turns out it's going to be a foul. He was hoping for a clean block, but the officials felt otherwise. So we'll see some free throws here.
It's been a solid outing for Little General. He has 12 points, and he's picked up one down. Boy, he's been a big contributor in this one.
Well, this isn't something they're going to see consistently from him, but they are enjoying his performance today.
Well, Clark, playing in New York can be nerve-rattling, and the Knicks had a lot of trouble last season getting wins here at home.
And, Kevin, if you look at where they ended up in the standings, a lot of it is because they just couldn't defend this court like they needed to.
Looking at who's out there now for the Knicks, Kyle O'Quinn is checked in for Williams, and it's a flawless in for Ricky Lito. Grant kicks to Kanan. He feeds it to Embiid. Six to shoot. Stauskas' shot is off.
As you mentioned, the Knicks' shortcomings started at home as they went sub 500 here. Teams just don't make the playoffs with a losing record on their home floor.
The wide open look here for Anthony. Connects in the foul line jumper. Anthony's got 25 points in the game. Philadelphia's gotten the three-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. 6 of 15. The pass to Holmes. The shot is off. And New York the other way now.
You know, it appeared to me that at times the Knicks did press a little too hard at home last year. They seemed to be forcing things that just weren't there in an effort to appease this very demanding New York Knicks crowd. And I think that pressure led to poor performance.
Grant kicks to Kanan. Out left to the wing. Philadelphia moving the ball around. And pushing it up. Here's New York. Grant dishes to O'Quinn. Moves back up. He takes it up and lays it in. And the Knicks lead by four. And a moment here to take a look at some of the hustle stats for the Knicks.
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ballgame.
And I'll tell you, the other thing that's been a factor is the transition game. They're scoring a lot of points on the fast break.
Timeout called, the 76ers. After like what we're seeing from Carmelo Anthony.
He's really taking it to him inside. They got to find a way to slow him down.
So for the Knicks, Amundsen comes in for the Bulldozer, and it's Calderon in for Grant. The 76ers making a switch here. And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Over that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear what Brett Brown said to his team. He told them, it's time to fight and take the lead. Let's put ourselves in position to bring it home. Guys, we'll see if they've got what it takes to get it done.
Thanks, Doris. It's Jackson with the drive. From past the arc. That one's in there. The Knicks lead is cut down to one on the bucket from Cannon.
And another three-pointer to their second half total.
Yeah, they caught that long-range bug at halftime, and it's been bombs away ever since.
There's the dish to Aflalo. The three from Anthony. Back to Aflalo. He kicks it to Calderon. He dishes it to Aflalo. Back to Calderon. The feed now to Amundsen. Six to shoot. That ball's nice feed this time from Jose Calderon.
One of the big stories is second chance point. It's just been terrific here in the second half in that area.
Kanan kicks to Grant. Here's Kanan. Pass to Aldemir. Jackson in the corner. Here's Embiid. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
You know, even from here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Yep, pretty obvious. And a good call by the official.
Well, it seems like they're having a lot of trouble at the line today, and it's just been that kind of a day.
Being down 2 points instead of one, thanks to the free throw miss, makes getting a stop here absolutely critical.
Calderon passes to O'Quinn. Back to Calderon. Kicks to O'Quinn. Dishes it to Calderon. Aflalo up top. Aflalo with another miss.
Great defense there. You really have to challenge him at that range.
No good from Grant.
Boy, that was a tough one, because if that goes down, you tie the score.
And you know they wanted it to go down. They put together a nice run. That would have tied.
And here's a follow for three. That's good.
I mean, what are you going to do defensively? Just rise up and bang down a three ball like that. They get such separation with the height advantage.
And the 76ers call time here.
Kyle O'Quinn in his third season out of Norfolk State, 6'10", but with a 7'5 wingspan and the strength to hold his own at the pivot. He has shown some promise for a player taken in the second round.
And the 76ers with a completely new group now. Now Roten. Feeds it to Covington. Passes it to Okafor. Shoots. Drops in the short one. And O'Quinn, a relatively ground-bound game. Not a big-time athlete.
Yeah, and very foul-prone defensively, in part because of that lack of athleticism. But he has shown the ability to knock down the mid-range jump shot. He's a hard worker, a quality young man, good rebounder and shot blocker. I think he's got a chance to be one of those guys that plays a long time and makes a nice contribution.
And assists like that typify their effort today. Great ball movement.
Really an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Boy, he's making it look really easy right now.
I expect them to continue to run the offense through him until the defense makes them change plans.
Now, here's Calderon. Not a lot of room. No good off the front iron.
Couldn't convert. A nice little two-man game there.
And it wouldn't surprise me to see them go back to that the next trip.
Out to the right wing. There's Covington. There's Noel. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
And at this stage of the game, that offensive rebound and putback is enormous. I mean, that feels like a four-point swing.
Calderon with it. And Roten picks him up defensively. Now, here's Calderon. Pass to Anthony. Three-pointer. And it's Noel with the rebound. Noel's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Thompson dishes to Roten. Okafor sets the pick for Roten. Now, Okafor inside. And he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Boy, a pick was set at the perfect angle on the floor, and he used it nice.
That's a play we may see from them a few more times.
Why not? I mean, when it works, you go back to it. Make them stop you.
It's Anthony with the drive. Rebound by the 76ers.
Tell you what, as well as he shot in the last quarter, Kevin, it's a total flip here in this one. He just can't get anything to go in the basket.
Covington kicks to Roten. Now Okafor inside. There's Noel, and he banks in the layup. Noel's got 4 this quarter.
Now they've done a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring in the paint.
Well, and that's why they're on this run, guys. They're getting the ball inside and getting really high percentage looks.
Aflalo, the pass to Anthony. They need this one. And that's 2 points on the layup. Anthony's got 11 points here in just the second half.
I don't know if he's tired or what, but he's finding it very difficult to score here in the fourth.
And Tony Roden with the slam. Tremendous stuff from a guy, Clark, we think more of for his passes.
Yeah, but he's got tremendous leaping ability and a surplus supply, too.
Well, that's a great aggressive move and two big points, too.
And the Knicks with possession here. A two-point game. Let's it go from 11. O'Quinn, head falls. Nice feed this time from Jose Calderon. Calderon's got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Here's Roten. Right through the D for the layup. Roten's got 34.
He's been working some magic out there today, guys. This lead has been largely his making.
Calderon dishes to Aflalo. He feeds it to Anthony. There's the pass to O'Quinn. Clock at six. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Covington's got three rebounds now in this one. Out left to the wing. Roten with it. Now guarded by Aflalo. The dish now to Thompson. Thompson right side. It's rebounded by New York. O'Quinn's got rebound number seven for him tonight. Noel with the block. And here's Thompson. He kicks to Okafor. 1:21 left in the fourth quarter. Drops in the layup for two. New York calls timeout. They're behind by four. 1:21 left in the fourth. Calderon with it. He dishes it to O'Quinn. Head balls. Nice speed this time from Jose Calderon. Calderon's got assist number eight now on the mound. 1:09 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Okafor kicks to Roten. There's the feed to Okafor. Pass to Noel. Just five to shoot. And the 76ers call time here. They're up by two. 55 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Checked in for Robert Covington. And it's the 76ers with the ball. They've led by as much as 10. Second chance shot. Here's Okafor. Connects!
Huge points.
That's beyond huge, Steve. I mean, they needed that bucket desperately.
This could be a turning point.
Kevin, critical possession here.
From deep, Aflalo. Again, Aflalo missing. And so they foul intentionally. And so they foul intentionally. First free throw is good, and that puts them up by five. And he is unable to get the second one.
Not as productive a trip to the line as he would have liked, but they're still in a pretty comfortable position.
Some nice passing by New York here. Anthony off the left rim and out. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Amundsen can't hit.
He's far too tentative in the paint, and even more so when the defender is up tight on him like that time.
The basket by Kanan.
And that puts a cherry on top, so to speak. It's been a phenomenal showing for them.
All over but the whining now, Steve.
New York calls timeout. They trail by seven. 12 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, what do you think?
Well, never say never, I guess. They just have no quit in them.
And I think you have to respect that attitude and approach. I know most teams would have called it a game already.
The Bulldozer! Knicks losing 94-99.
Here's Roten. Misses there. So the 76ers win it. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr.